Hello. I have read my textbook and looked at my notes, but I am still getting confused about the difference between independent and dependent variables.
Do you know the types of research designs that have independent variables?
Yes, they are used in quantitative research studies, in both true experimental and quasi-experimental studies.
Yes. In these types of studies, the researcher usually wants to learn about the effectiveness of a treatment or intervention. They give this treatment or intervention to an experimental group, but not to participants in the control group.
I know that part. The experimental group gets the intervention, and the researcher then has a control group that either gets no intervention or an alternative intervention. In drug trials, the control group usually gets a placebo. So, if an intervention is supposed to help people with dementia to increase their engagement in leisure activities, then the researchers would need to measure engagement in leisure activities before and after the intervention.
And they will need to do this for both the participants in the experimental group and for the research participants who are in the control group who do not get the intervention.
I understand all of that, but I get confused about which is the independent and which is the dependent variable.
We are about to get to that. Do you understand that in both of the studies that we have discussed, the researchers are looking at cause and effect?
I guess that makes sense. In the drug study, the researchers want to know if the new drug causes an effect on blood pressure.
And in the dementia study, the researchers want to know if their intervention causes an effect on engagement in leisure activities.
That makes sense.
So, the dependent variable is the one that is dependent on the drug or intervention.
And the independent variable?
The independent variable is the intervention that the researcher gives to the experimental group but does not give to the control group. Then, if this intervention has an effect, this effect will be dependent on the intervention.
Oh, that makes sense. So, the drug would be the independent variable, and because the researchers think the drug will affect the participant's blood pressure would be the dependent variable.
Exactly. It is the dependent variable because the researcher's hypothesis is that blood pressure is dependent on having or not having the new drug. Measuring the dependent variable before and after the intervention allows researchers to measure the change in the dependent variable for both groups.
Is that why researchers need operational definitions of their dependent variables?
Well, in quantitative research, researchers need operational definitions that explain how they will measure or quantify the dependent variable. We need a way to measure blood pressure or a way to measure engagement in leisure if we are going to quantify the changes that occur during the study.
So, when you talk about pre-tests and post-tests, you mean that the researcher is using the operational definition of the dependent variable to measure changes that occur during the study.
That's right. And if the experimental group has a bigger change in the dependent variable than the control group, the difference was probably caused by the effect of the independent variable.
And by independent variable, you mean the drug or intervention. Is that the idea?
It sounds like you understand. So, why would we call engagement in leisure the dependent variable in the other study?
Because the researchers believe that the changes in engagement in leisure will be dependent on their intervention. They probably expect that the intervention will cause an increase in engagement for most of the participants in the experimental group.
That is correct. Remember to continue to practice using these words to explain different types of studies. It always takes practice to learn how to use new terminology. Without this kind of practice, you may forget some of the things that you understand today. If you practice, your brain will store this information in your long-term memory. And the best way to practice is...
I know. I should explain all of this to someone else.
Yes, helping others in this way will help you learn too. Thanks for coming to my office. I hope that it helped.
Yes, it was helpful. Thanks.
For more information on quantitative research, remember to read your textbook and work to use the information that you find there. Apply the terms and concepts that you are learning to your own examples. You need to talk about these ideas if you want to really learn them. Once you understand something, teach it to others. Bye.
Goodbye.